Hello, this video is about finding the inverse of a function. So in this example, we've been told the function g of x is to subtract 10 and square root it. So it's square root of x minus 10. And you're asked to find the inverse, often written like this, g to the minus 1 of x. The idea is that the inverse should return your answer back to the question, if you like. So it undoes the function. So how to do it? There's a simple, kind of weird way of doing it I always recommend, which is take this function here and write it out again, but instead of an x, put a different letter. So let's say y. Let's not be too clever. Y minus 10, and make that equal to x. And then you're going to rearrange to make y the subject, and then you'll find you've answered the question. So we're going to square both sides. Only ever do that if you've got a square root completely covering, you only have one term. If you have multiple terms, squaring it gets messy, so just be careful. But this will work. Y minus 10 equals x squared, and then move the 10 over, y equals x squared plus 10, and that is the inverse function. We've done it. You can knock that out and say g to the minus 1 of x is x squared plus 10. Let's just test this. I'm going to imagine a number. I'm going to say x is 19. Do the function on x. So 19 take away 10 is 9. Square root it is 3. Now let's put 3 into this and see if we get back to 19. 3 squared, 9 plus 10 is 19. It works. Very hard to get that wrong. No, it is. It's possible to get it wrong. So just be careful with your algebra. Should all be straightforward. Thanks for watching. Hope that was helpful.